Sit down.
Good soup, girly.
Tommy, the salad tastes like
that.
That's
kind of cheesy.
It just comes out.
You know, she's videoing an
actual. Okay, now. How do you like your goulash soup? What is that?
You took a picture.
No! You just put the night shot on. Well, how do you do it? Your finger's in the way. How do you do it?
We didn't do it, Tiger. The light popped up.
No, you did do it. You did do it, because I'm looking at it still.
That needs something.
Oh, he's ready to go.
Everyone's like, why is he using an opera voice?
How's the goulash, Dag? Hardy.
Finally got food.
Try the dumpling.
She made biscuits.
The Wiener Schnitzel. Boiled beef.
That's good. Yes.
And your potatoes taste like nanny. I
need more.
I'm bored.
Wanna go for a little snack? It's got the Venice feel to it, though.
Backpack?
What?
He can't find his backpack.
So that's
fall.
I don't know where it is. He has pepper. Or maybe this is salt. This must be salt, not sugar. That's what that is. You
have to
taste it,
girl.
I'm telling you,
it's salt. I don't put sugar on my
It's better to put sugar on your eggs and salt.
Hey, Dag, where are we having breakfast now? And what day is it?
Get a snapshot of that.
What is it?
I don't know.
What day?
Christmas Eve day. Day three, yes.
Yeah, I can put this on my computer now and I can put like day three at the bottom.
But you fell asleep when you were snoring.
Yeah.
And you woke up.
Thanks, young fella.
The water's good here. Yeah. I woke up like 15 minutes. Took a bath, took a shower.
You did? You took a bath?
Yeah. You smell pretty good, fella.
Yeah, it was too hot.
Didn't have to leave the number?
I sent you your number, and he said, yes, good morning.
But it's not here right now.
Position, Peter. It's been 1 minute, Dag. The plane hit the queue.
The little...
Okay, now we go to the mural.
First street. Is that anywhere near?
No, that's close to your hotel, actually.
Is there an emergency hatch back there, Dag?
Very good. Sorry.
What happened?
I got the tickets.
Finally. Let me get close up.
It didn't flash, didn't need to. It's done.
Pop the flash first.
It's done, man. I don't think it.
I'll be speaking in English today, only English. I hope that's okay with everyone.
Yes.
Your driver, his name is Ted. He's going to take good care of us. Ted, want to say hi?
Hey, Teddy.
Hi, Ted.
Hi, Teddy.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ted would like me to ask you folks, please, no smoking on his bus. Yay. Bus all day. We'll get off several times. As a matter of fact, out in the countryside, you'll have some free time for yourselves in a wonderful little village where they film the wedding scene for The Sound of Music. And it's a great place for apple strudel.
Oh, yeah.
But first, yeah. What do you think about Salzburg? Isn't this a wonderful place?
Yeah!
You know, ladies and gentlemen, the way you see Salzburg, this city was founded in the year 696 by a bishop who came here as a missionary. Well, that man's name was Rupert. He was from Worms, now part of Germany. For over 1,000 years, the city has been ruled by prince archbishops under authority of the Pope. Salzburg only belonged to Austria since 1816. It belonged to Bavaria 6 years before that. 1 year before then, it belonged to France when Napoleon invaded the city. Well, one of the more famous prince archbishops that ruled Salzburg was a man called Wolf Dietrich from Reichenau. Among other buildings, he built a beautiful palace called the Mirabel Palace, which is just across the street to the right. You'll see it when we make this right turn. He built the palace, you'll see, for his mistress and their 16 children. Today, the palace houses the government offices for Salzburg. It's not worth visiting. But what's worth visiting and really important for us is behind that palace and behind the wall in front of us there, the Mirabel Gardens. 5 scenes of The Sound of Music were filmed back there, and all those scenes had to do with that Do-Re-Mi song. If you were to walk through the front gate of that palace, go through the courtyard inside of it and out the back door, you'd just about fall right into the Pegasus water fountain. That's where Maria and the children danced around the fountain as they were singing the Do-Re-Mi song. Has anybody seen this movie? Okay, you'll remember the scene. Me? Have I seen it? Remember the scenes, Maria. The children were running through an ivy-covered walkway. That ivy-covered walkway's back there. How about the scene where the children were jumping from one step to the next? Each step a different note of this song. Remember, the first step would be Do. A deer, a female, a deer. Alright, that's exactly, okay, that's enough. That was from back there too. What about the scene not too many people remember though? The children were skipping by a little statue of a dwarf. And as they were skipping by, hang on, that she remembers. That's right, that was from back there too. What about one of my favorite scenes? Maria sees 2 great big statues of handsome-looking, muscular men. The statues are on each side of a road, sticking their arms out of each other, kind of like this. Remember, Maria saw those statues. She got so excited when she saw them, she grabbed the children. They ran right between those statues. They stuck their arms out in the air, just like those statues were doing, as they were just about getting ready to finish that song. Remember that? Well, that was a Now you might be wondering, well, why aren't we going back there to see those things? Well, the honest truth is we really don't have the time for it. We've got a lot of things to see and do. We're going to be way out in the countryside. We just don't have the time. The good thing is, when we get back from this tour, we'll be stopping right at the Mirabel Palace. You can see all those things on your own. Doesn't cost anything. And you can take as much time as you like. So we can have some time too. Did you know this movie, The Sound of Music, is popular all over the world? It's popular everywhere, except for right here in Salzburg. Not too many Austrians like this movie, The Sound of Music, and there's a good reason for it. The movie actually started out as a German movie. A German film company bought the rights to a book Maria wrote about her life. They gave her the equivalent of $9,000. The Germans called their movie The Trapp Family Singers. Their movie was such a great success, the Germans decided to make the sequel to their movie called The Trapp Family Singers in America. And that's when 20th Century Fox got really jealous. They saw just how well those Germans were doing with their movie. They thought they could make an even better version. Well, the Germans refused to sell. That's when the Americans got really smart. They started the Broadway play, that musical called The Sound of Music. The music was by Rodgers and Hammerstein. The lead role of Maria was played by a woman called Mary Martin. You might remember her from Peter Pan. South Pacific. She said it, J.R.'s mom. Larry Hagman's mother. Larry Hagman, about 2 years ago, had a liver transplant. He's doing fine. But anyway, that play lasted 4.5 years on Broadway. They won 7 Tony Awards, and it wasn't until then that finally 20th Century Fox did get the rights to the movie. They made their own version. Well, they decided not to base their version on the original story like the Germans did. They based their version more or less on the Broadway play, made a kind of a musical themselves. And that's why this movie, The Sound of Music, is popular all over the world, except for right around here in Salzburg and the surrounding areas. Most Austrians here that have seen this movie, well, they've had a chance to see the German version, and they know about all the liberties Hollywood took with their version. Hollywood never wanted to make a documentary-type film of the Trapp family. They wanted to make a wonderful musical. They could have cared less about Maria von Trapp or her story. Well, Maria von Trapp got so mad at Hollywood at one point, she threatened on going to the newspapers and telling them what a terrible thing they were doing. They ended up giving her $900,000. She was what? And they took his suggestions as well. Let's face it, they came up with the greatest musical ever produced. Who doesn't love this movie? It gave me a job, too. Well, we're going to take you a little bit through Salzburg now. Coming up in front of us to the right is the Café Bazaar. If you drink a cup of coffee in there, you'll be awake for 3 days. Boy, they have some strong coffee here. That's that Turkish culture. You know, the Turks ran over Austria, so they took the coffee culture here. Woo, look at the sun. There's the big fortress in front of us. We'll drive behind it. When we do, I promise you, I'll tell you all about the fortress. But look to the right. See that place called Winkler up on the hill? If you haven't been up there yet, you're missing one of the most wonderful views of Salzburg. There are elevator rides going up there. Now, the Winkler is not open. It used to be a cafe, but they've closed it. They're going to put a museum up there. But it's the view that's fantastic. You can walk from the Winkler all the way to the fortress. It takes about 30 minutes. Halfway to the fortress, you'll find steps going back down into the city. So you go on a one-way ticket up there, walk towards the fortress. That building to its left is a youth hostel that's only open in the summer. Cheap rooms, a wonderful view. Yes, this is the old city of Salzburg you're looking at on the other side of this river. The river is called the Salzach River. This river runs to the Danube in the Black Sea. Ach is an old Celtic word, the Mem River. That was a Celtic settlement. Salz meant salt. It's the transport salt down this river. Look to the hard right. Notice that church with the red roof, the green steeple. Does everybody see that? Well, ladies and gentlemen, keep that church in your minds. Connected onto the right side of that church is the city's largest beer hall, the Augustiner Brau, with enough seating for 2,000 beer drinkers. And the best thing about that beer hall is, it's right next door to it, is the city's largest hospital. Let yourself go there. Big leader-wise, ceramic mugs of beer. You'll want to go to visit that place. I'll give you directions how to get there once we get back from the tour. Not more than a 15-minute walk from the Mirabelle Palace. Opens at 3, closes at 11, and stops serving beer at 9. So at 9 o'clock, you should order at least 20 beers. Look at this pedestrian bridge on the left. It was featured in The Sound of Music. At the other end, run in our direction, Maria and the children in their drapery clothes, singing the Do-Re-Mi song. This is the bridge they ran across right here. If you were on the other side, you'd see the fortress behind us here. Look at those beautiful buildings on the left, on the other side of the river over there. There was a great fire in 1818 that destroyed everything over there almost. Most of the buildings were built right after that. These are the wealthy Austrians that live there, of course. They get subsidies from the government to keep them up real nice, and they rent the bottom floors out to lawyers and doctors. Ted, a bus driver, has a house there. He lives under the bridge. He said he's got running water. Okay, I'm going to make it interesting now. I'm going to play out some scenes of the movie. I'll ask questions. The first person that can yell out the answer wins a free beer. Look at this party. Oh, a soft drink. Want to try? Okay, think carefully. You remember the scene singing this song. How do you solve a problem like Maria? Remember that? You remember all of a sudden the camera pans off to a mountain. We see Maria up on a mountain picking flowers. Remember, all of a sudden, Maria heard the bells to the abbey? She knew she was late, so she grabbed all of her things as quickly as she could. She went running down this mountain for the abbey. She forgot her hat, though, didn't she? She ran back and picked it up. Well, then she ran down this mountain for the abbey. She got to the abbey. She broke through the front gates, ran across the courtyard, stopped at a water pump, splashed water on her face, then went running off the other side. Well, if you remember, the whole time the Reverend Mother and some of the nuns were watching Maria. All of a sudden, Maria saw the Reverend Mother and she stopped, dead in her tracks, just walked calmly off as if nothing happened. Remember that scene? Everybody good with that?
Yes.
Okay, the question's in the next scene. Now, all of a sudden, Maria gets called into the Reverend Mother's office. Now, she thinks she's been caught. So, as soon as she gets in the door, she starts saying things kind of like this. Oh, I'm so sorry, Oslette. I'm so sorry. But I was on a mountain. It was my mountain. I was born there. It was such a beautiful day. I kept climbing higher and higher. Oh, I knew I wouldn't get lost. Please, can you forgive me? What do you think about my acting? That is very good, isn't it? The old trick. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, think carefully now because this is for the beer. In that scene, Maria named that mountain. Does anyone here remember the name?
Yeah.
What'd you say? She said the Undersberg. And she won a beer! Round of applause for that lady there. Congratulations! Now when we get out in the countryside, I'll get you drunk. Undersberg. Here's a sign with a red name. And there's a lot of beer here too.
Yes.
It's called the Undersberg, and in just a few moments, I'm going to point out the Undersberg for you. But before I do, there's some interesting things coming up here I'd like to show you. Nobody knows where this strange building is here on the right. But look at that beautiful building in front of us there to the right. That was built at the turn of the century. It was an old folks home then. It is an old folks home now. You can tell it's an old folks home if you walk up to it. There are busts of older people all over the front of it, so you know what it is. You know that main shopping street where Mozart's birthplace is in Salzburg? You see these wonderful handmade wrought iron signs with pictures on the outside. What's in the stores? A lot of people couldn't read, so they put pictures here. Lots of older people. Look at this view. What do you think? Here's the backside of the fortress. Now, the fortress is called Hohensalzburg, and that means high salt fortress. So you folks on the left here will be driving back down this way, and when we do, I promise all of you, I'll tell you about the fortress. But you notice this little house on our right in this field all by itself, no other houses around it? That was the executioner's house. Nobody liked that guy. Didn't want to live near him. Now, he had to take care of the vegetable gardens down here as well. He always practiced by cutting lettuce heads first. Well, ladies and gentlemen, look to the left in the clearing. You'll get to see the Untersberg behind the trees here.
Wow, look at the
mountains. Just to the hard left, there it is, the Untersberg. Well, use your imaginations a little bit. The Untersberg over there is about 6,000 feet high. The Untersberg is about 10 kilometers away from Salzburg. Maria ran down that mountain. She ran all the way back to the city to the Abbey in about 3 minutes. This woman was an athlete. Could have been the flying nun. Do you remember the very last scene of this movie? The Trapp family are in their hiking clothes. They're escaping to Switzerland. That was filmed on that same mountain, the Untersberg. Well, there's only one thing wrong with this scene. The Untersberg is half in Austria, the other half is in Germany. They were going the wrong way. It's about 500 kilometers in that direction. Could you imagine poor little Gretel through all that water? Well, now you know. These are only some of the liberties Hollywood took with this movie, and that's why the Austrians, especially here in Salzburg, don't really care for this movie. But that's fine, because we love this movie. You know, you'll be happy to know they were able to film the beginning and closing scenes of The Sound of Music on that mountain, the Untersberg, thanks to the cable cars running up and down it. From what I understand now, they just finished safety checks on the cable cars they're running again. If you want to go, bus number 55 will take you to the base of the Untersberg, right at those cable cars. It's a wonderful idea for the afternoon when we get back. Now, bus 55 starts at the train station, but it'll pick you up just to the right of the Mirabel Palace when we get back. You might consider going there. Well, we're not going to be on this bus all day. As a matter of fact, our first stop is coming up in just a few moments. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to leave some of your valuables on this bus whenever we get off, feel free. Ted, my bus driver, is a professional. He takes his job seriously. He'll make sure nobody gets on this bus when we're off of it. And if Ted decides to get off this bus on any of these stops, he'll lock it up. Always does. Your things should be perfectly fine where they are. Now, we'd like to ask you to please keep the seats you've got right now throughout the entire tour. Please do not take someone else's seat. We almost had a great big fist fight on this bus 3 weeks ago. Can you imagine, out in the countryside, we all got back on the bus, one guy decided to sit down next to this other guy's girlfriend. He started flirting with a girl, and the other guy pounced on him. We had to pull them apart. Since then, Ted here has been learning karate. Be careful. He's a pretty good Wow, look at this big yellow sign coming up on the right. It says Freibad Leopold's Krone. This is a swimming area that can handle 5,000 swimmers. Freibad means open bathing. Leopold's Krone means the crown of Leopold. Now that was a terrible Prince Archbishop. That man in 1736 threw 22,000 Protestants out of Salzburg. 300 of those Protestants went to the United States, a place called Ebenezer near Savannah, Georgia. Visit Savannah. Great big statue there commemorating those Protestants. Look here. There's the fortress once. Not you, Ted. There's the fortress once again. Going softer. But right now, we've made it at our very first stop. So, ladies and gentlemen, as soon as Ted stops his bus here, I'm going to hop out first and I'll run to the back. I'm going to show you folks sitting on that jump seat back there how that seat works. You can all get out the back door then as well as this front one. Follow me, please. And please be careful. It's a little bit icy out here, too, when you get off.
That's the sky. Freezing.
Listen.
You know, in those days, in 1964, they were using gigantic cameras called Todd AO Vision. You might just remember Mike Todd, one of Elizabeth's
going to a village, it's a village.
Well, those cameras needed a lot of electricity and lighting. The Austrian authorities just happened to walk in there while they were
in
the house. And they almost had to stop the movie. Somebody got smart, though. They called up Hollywood. They sent two artists. The artists came back. They sketched the interiors of all the other buildings. Fortress once again, this time I'd like to show you something I think is really important about the fortress. In the meantime, on this wall on our right, at the entrance of that building with the red roof on it, what you'll see is a sign in English, underneath it in German. The sign says, private property, trespassers will be prosecuted, including tour groups. That's when they had all the problems with the gazebo. When we were back there, we used to jump over these walls with our guests just to go look at it. They didn't like that. Here's the sign right here. The front of the palace over here was never used in the Sound of Music. It's too important. Coming up, it's not as important. You want to hear a funny joke?
Yes.
Okay. What happened to the guy with no left side? He's all right. Get it? Ted told me that just an Austrian joke. Thanks, Ted. So ladies and gentlemen, right after we make this right curve, look to the left. When you see the fortress this time, please notice the three towers that are up there. Notice the tower on the very left side with a flagpole on it. Does everyone?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the Prince Archbishop's toilet. Bombs away! And that is the truth. If you decide to take a tour up there, they should show it to you. It's a gravity toilet. Doesn't the fortress look kind of strange, though? Three towers on the left side, a jagged roof in the middle. The right side has a normal-looking roof on it. Well, there's a good reason for that. They started the construction on that fortress in the year 1077. They finished it 600 years later. The reason was, each prince archbishop that lived up there decided to add on to the fortress in the style and way he wanted to. I've been told that is the biggest, best preserved medieval fortress in Europe. If you'd like to take a tour up there, if you haven't done so yet, there are two ways to get up there. One of those is by funicular, the train running up and down the hill, and the other is by foot. There's a footpath going up there, but I'd consider it if I was you. It's pretty slippery right now, really steep. The sign at the beginning says it takes 20 minutes to get up there, and that's in the summer. Well, once you are up there, and you decide to take one of their tours, not only will they show you the toilet I told you about, they'll show you a beautiful museum. You can see weaponry that was used in those days. It was really ugly-looking clothes the nuns gave her to wear. She was scared. Everybody has to buy their last and second Christmas presents. Hang around with the lights, traffic light. Well, ladies and gentlemen, in the clearing on the right, you'll see the Untersberg once again, the site of the beginning, closing scenes of the Sound of Music. Right behind it, Hitler's Eagle's Nest, Bavaria, right behind that mountain. Bert has gotten an ancient Bavarian village. It's only about 40 minutes drive to it. But anyway, once we get past the last trees on the left, look to the left and you'll see the building that was used as the front of the Montrap Villa in The Sound of Music. Now, it's not this beautiful building, right after the trees. That wall over there, that's where Maria was skipping on the road, swinging her guitar in her suitcase as the front of the Montrap Villa. Now, I'm sorry to say the road over there is reserved for pedestrians, horseback riding and bicycling. But what about that tree-lined alleyway to the right of the place? That's where the children were hanging, Max and the Baroness in the car with him. He looked up, saw those children in their drapery clothes, and he thought to himself, oh no, that's not my kids. Ted the bus driver! He's seen this movie. His castle. Whenever you walk by those things, they squirt water at you. This guy had a great sense of humor. Some kinds of laughing and screaming. It's unfortunate because this place is closed for the winter. But even so, I'll show you something I think is beautiful. Now, Ted's going to make a left turn over here. As soon as he does, look to the right. Because up on a hill, you see a fantastic little castle. It's called the Month Castle. M-O-N-T-H. Now, that's an unusual name for a castle, but there's a reason for the name. It was built as a joke. Look to the right, you'll see it. There it is. You know, this area to our right here was built between the years of 1613 and 1619. Well, it took them 6 years to build all of this. 1 month before they finished the construction here, some friends of Marcus Siticus made a bet with him. They bet him he couldn't build that little castle on the hill and finish this place all of the last month of construction. Well, Marcus Siticus took the bet on, made his workers. Okay, thank you. Shows I was talking about on the bus, done behind that castle right there in the summer. Used mainly as a hunting lodge in the old days. But you know, we don't really care about the castle. We're going this way. Who likes it? Doesn't it look small? Yeah. You know, this gazebo you're looking at was used only on the outside shots. They had to build a half gazebo in the studios in Hollywood for all the inside shots because they couldn't get the cameras or lighting right here in this one. They've locked those doors. 2 years ago, an 80-year-old woman fell down and broke her hip trying to dance from one pit of the next like Ralph and Elisa were doing. This plaque on this wall right here commemorates the gazebo to the city of Salzburg. And by the way, there are restrooms here behind the tree in the building over there. You can certainly go and use those if you need to. Have your photographs. Our next stop's going to be the lakes and mountains region. Please get back to the bus as quickly as possible.
Okay.
Oh.
Yeah, you three stand right here. Look at that picture. Very nice picture.
You should take it out of the screen. We're not all going to be able to.
Okay, hold on. One more here. All right. Yeah, out here.
Oh. Very nice. No, do it now. Do it now.
All right. All right. You can do it, money. Hold on. Got it.
Now don't move. Wait, don't move. I want your camera, Tommy. Oh, that came out very nice.
All right, I think Teddy's almost ready. Teddy's ready.
You hear him yodeling?
Teddy was yodeling?
No, the other guy.
All right, go ahead, scoot back to the bus.
Okay, we hope everybody's on the bus now. Bus 55 will bring you out here. The zoo's open, but the Monk Castle water shows when they're going on to the left.
You want to know what the numbers are?
They use that building today as a school. They teach children music there. A special method of teaching music called the Orff Method. The Carl Orff Method. There's another beautiful building coming up in front of us to the right. It used to be a palace belonging to Empress Sissy Elizabeth. Then it was a 5-star hotel, and now they've changed it into a shopping mall. That's right, they're going to sell Austrian clothing here as well. Later, some things like that. A flower, and then giving it to her. Now, the only thing wrong with that is the flower has almost been picked to death. You can hardly find it up there anymore. So it's against the law to pick the flower nowadays. Well, the Austrians are smart. They grow that flower in hot houses and they sell them to the tourists anyway. And believe me, they've seen the tourists coming. They'll actually sell you Edelweiss seeds. All you need is a mountain. Now, you folks are lucky because you don't have to buy any Edelweiss seeds at all. I've got Edelweiss seeds here for everybody on this bus. Once we get out into the lakes and mountains region, I'm going to come to the back of the bus, hand out every one of you some Edelweiss seeds.
Yay!
Yeah, Ted's okay. That's where everything in reality happened. This movie was loosely based on what really happened. Now, the Baron's wife died giving birth out of the 30 Years' War in the 1770s. Ladies and gentlemen, the pedestrian bridge. There it is. Marie and the children ran across in a drapery close. Notice that steeple way back behind it? That's where the Augustiner Row is, the beer hall. In just a few moments now, well, we want to get started into the lakes and mountains region.
I know I will hear. just took a snapshot. I saw that. Sun's blind to me. Here we go.
It's gonna sun crack out. Watch that.
Whatever you get going here, we're gonna get on a. Yeah, hold that.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, it's recording. Thanks, Dad. Why not?
Don't. Because then we might miss something
up. But ladies and gentlemen, in just a few moments now, coming up in front of the bus, you'll see our very first lake on the tour. All the lakes you'll be seeing on this tour were featured in The Sound of Music at that opening panoramic scene. Our first lake coming up, you'll see in a moment, is called Fushel, drinking quality water. Now this lake normally freezes in the winter, and when it does, they'll actually hold ice sailboat races on it. On this end, it's a pretty tough golf course. Two of the fairways on the side of this hill. No matter what you do, the ball rolls all the way down to the bottom. They give you two pairs of socks when you play this golf course, in case you get a hole-in-one. Now, this next building coming up in front of us to the left here is famous for its vegetables, wild meats. If you'd like to eat a wild animal, this is the place to come to right here. Every week, they'll have a roadkill special. Once we get to the other end of the lake, you'll notice a little town of Fushel, same name as the lake. Well, you'll notice that the town has not been commercialized, which really is nice. You know, the Austrians living out here in the countryside, well, they like to rent part of their own homes out. If you ever see the word Zimmer on a building, that means room. Zimmer frei means room available, or pension, same as bed and breakfast. It really is nice. It gives the Austrians living here a chance to make a little extra money, and visitors a chance to see what real Austrian families are like, what it's like to live with them. Besides all that, it keeps the character and atmosphere of these towns small and Austrian. It keeps most of the big hotels away. Now, we're not going to stop at this lake, but we will be stopping at the lake right after this one. The one we'll be stopping at makes this one here look. Is the Von Tourist Trap Shop is closed for the season. But the good news is there's another trap shop that is open. That's open. Okay, so in just a moment, I'll point out the little town of...
What will my future be? I wonder. It could be so exciting to be out in the world, to be free. My heart should be wildly rejoicing.
Oh,
what's the matter? To do the wrong. I am more certain.
Now you can spend the night up there in that hotel only in the spring, summer, and fall. Only because the water freezes or they can't get water up to it in the winter. But you can spend the night up there for 550 shillings. That includes...
Louis boy?
Maybe. She's home. Maybe not. Now there's normally several gift shops you can look in down here, but unfortunately for the winter, most all of them are closed. But you're lucky. One woman has a shop that's open. She has the most wonderful handmade Austrian linens, things like that, cuckoo clocks, beer steins. Ladies, she has really nice Austrian women to know. And men too. You know what else? She's got a little teddy bear. If you press its stomach, it yodels. Strange things too. But please remember one thing. This is not here. It's the only thing. It's private cars and regional buses. No train service coming up here. And I'll show you where the bus stop is. Look to the left on top of the mountain. There's that hotel. It's called the Schaffbergspitze. Make sure you look at a postcard down here. You get a close-up view of it. You can see seven different lakes when you're up there. It's an amazing sight. But another amazing sight, just in front of us to the left, they'll have diving contests over there. Some Austrians like to call that the Acapulco of Austria. We call it suicide. Have you got time and money? You could go on a hot air balloon ride. They even do it in the winter because they figure if the wind blows, it's blowing the balloon and you won't feel it. Now in the summertime, when the conditions are perfect, they'll actually bring you down the lake, get your feet wet, then go back up into the sky. Use your dad's credit card. Coming up in the clearing on the left, you should see the cable cars. They should be running. Yes, they are running. There they are on the left. They did safety checks for the longest time. 1952, they built those cable cars. There's a restaurant on that rock. Just so there's enough time for some.
They always just leave me behind. Oh, this is beautiful here. Oh, look at that.
Okay, I got it. If I can figure it out, yeah. Everything in here is digital, so anything digital you can send anyway.
Oh, see, then I didn't have to bring my digital camera. You've been taking pictures with that. That's a cool one.
Where'd they all go?
Doesn't it smell nice and fresh?
Oh, nice. Got it. Should put a back lid in. Yeah, you three, get. Okay, got it.
Do you want me to take a picture of you?
In a minute.
Okay. How do you like the trip so far?
Yeah, it's fine.
It's good. Say, good, yeah.
It's good.
Yeah.
All right, hold on, I'll take the back lane off. All right.
Wow.
Avalanche.
Yeah.
No, the lady's nothing. The lady's nothing. But you have that. In summer, you have a
winter. All in my legs. I couldn't think of it last night. I was so tired. All I did was put her string.
You got the boots.
Was that the right amount?
17. Nah,
that didn't come out good. Eager young lads and offer you food and wine. Totally unprepared are you to face a world of men. Older and wiser.
What am I looking at?
Nothing, I got it.
Oh, I didn't know what you were doing.
I am 16, going on 17. I know that I'm naive. Fellows,
one more.
I meet, they tell me I'm sweet, and willingly I believe. I am 16, going to Desiree's. Bachelor dandies, drinkers of rye, to face a world of men.
This is a nice view.
Shy and scared am I of things beyond my ken.
Yeah, lucky.
I need someone under and wiser telling me what to do. You are 17.
There are people in the water down there.
What?
There are people in the water down there. Two in a boat and one standing in it.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we drive around down this curve and the next one, look in front of the bus, you'll see a beautiful castle. The castle, just like the Annie Nicole Smith story, right here. When we pass that castle, look to the right, you see the man's little lake behind it. He owns the lake. The lake he owns is called the Croton Say. Well, he calls it his swimming pool. It's deep. It's one of the deeper lakes, almost 100 meters deep. That man made a lot of his money through cement. We're not exactly sure where some of his old girlfriends ended up. We know the man is pretty set in his ways, but we don't have any concrete.
Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel and noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes. Snowflakes
look at here.
My nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. Sad. Remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel. Favorite things.
Oh, look at the
fog. Green-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings.
Yeah, hold on.
These are a few of my favorites. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes. The thing, when the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad.
Had to be rebuilt in the early 17th century, though, after a great big fire. It's the same church Julie Andrews came back to in 1987 with John Denver and Placido Domingo. They filmed a special for television here called The Sound of Christmas.
Oh, that's a fire.
They filmed that in the middle of July. To make everything around here look like Christmas, Hollywood sprayed all the trees they were using with soap. The Austrians thought they were completely crazy. There's a secret. Ask for the hot vanilla sauce with your apple strudel. It's wonderful. It's something you can't get everywhere. Or try the cheese strudel with the hot vanilla sauce. That's only about 1 million calories. What we'll do, when we get to the town of Molise, I'll let you know exactly how much time we have and when we should be back on the bus. I'll walk you into the town. I'll point out St. Michael's for you. I'll point out Mrs. Brown's. And then, of course, You'll be free to do anything you like. And by the way, you are allowed to take flash photography inside the church if you want to, but you'll have to remember, this is a functioning church. The priest has been known to throw people out for being too loud in there. He doesn't mind you taking flash photography, though. Ladies and gentlemen, as we drive around this curve for the rest of the way, let's look at our watches now. 12:18 here at the front of the bus. Does everybody have 12:18? Okay, so when Ted finishes parking, please follow me.
Wait, did you see that?
Ready? Lucky.
I was talking, you had to wait till I stopped. I was trying to tell you.
Where are we going, girlie?
Mrs. Burns.
For the Apostle. What are you gonna have, Tiger?
Some
strudel.
Why is that blinking?
The tape's almost gone.
An extra?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Well, this was only 60 today.
So how are you enjoying it? Yes. We didn't know what you wanted. What do you want? I know, because it's only a minute left. Yes. One more tape for today. Huh? One more tape for today or the whole trip? I know, that's what I was concerned about.
But it doesn't say like men's or women's. I just went in there.
No.
I don't have to go anyway. I just want to
check myself. It's a cold open sandwich. Instead of a hot open sandwich, it's a cold open sandwich. So Jeff, the boss hasn't told me there's no shaving in the salad. Does he ask for mayonnaise?
Oh, I don't know.
What is this? Cheese?